In forward of this book, Anne-Marie Schimmel says, "To write about Sufism or Islamic mysticism is an almost impossible task because the topic Islamic mysticism is a wide subject. The subject will understand to the readers how writer approached it. The first chapter is, what is Sufism? In recent years, many books have been published on Sufism. Each of them has touched upon a different facet. For the phenomenon usually called Sufism is so broad and its appearances so profane that nobody can venture to describe it fully, like the blind man in Rumi's famous story. Schimmel says the Sufism generally accepted name for Islamic mysticism. The mysticism contained something mysterious. The word mysticism and mystery derived from the Greek mein. It is means to close the eyes. Schimmel gave a general definition for mysticism. Mysticism is the great spiritual current which grows throughout all religion. Schimmel is saying, mysticism can be defined as love of the absolute for the power or the ultimate power. Schimmel classified mysticism into two types. First one, mysticism of infinity, and second, mysticism of personality. Schimmel described in this chapter the history of Islamic mysticism and how Europe started to translate the Sufic literature and what was the different perspective of Islamic Sufism between scholars. Also, she is trying in this part to address some European scholars who studied about Islamic mysticism and some mystic literatures. The second chapter is historical outline of classical Sufism. Schimmel defined in this chapter, Islamic mysticism is the attempt to reach individual salvation through attaining the true Tawheed, means there is no deity but Allah. The chapter includes about some mystical leaders of the late 9th century. Also, Schimmel here mentions about the famous mystic Al-Hallaj. She says about Hallaj, the martyr of mystical love and the period of consolidation from Shibli radiyallahu anhu to Imam Ghazali. Especially she says the connection of Sufism with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Sahaba with mentioning the word Ahlus Sufa. Third chapter is The Path. In this section, Schimmel explains about the foundation of the path. She says, mystic in every religious tradition have tended to describe the different steps on the way that leads towards God by the image of the path. What is the path? The path was defined by writer as Tariqa, Sharia and Haqiqa. The writer also exposes here about Makama, it means station, and Hal, state. The difference between station and state, Hal and Makama. State is something that descends from God into man's heart without his being able to repel it when it comes or to attract it when it goes by his own effort. as Rumi puts it poetically, Dihal, it means state, is like unveiling of beauteous bride, while the Makam, station, it means station, is the being alone with the bride. The fourth chapter is Man and His Perfection. Shimal reveals in this area some notes on Sufi psychology, like Man Arafa Nafsahu Arafa Rabbha, such as that word, and what is the role of Satan in the determination of good and bad, and the period of consolidation from Imam Shibli to Imam Ghazali. In this part, the writer attempts to discuss the position of man in Islam and especially in Sufism. It has been a subject of controversy among Western scholars. The fifth chapter is Sufi Orders and Fraternities. The writer classifies in this chapter about the community life of a mystic, such what is the major reason to share mystic's life with social communities. Shimal puts forward a new thought, Al-Mu'minu Mir'atul Mu'min. The faithful is the mirror of the faithful. That is a prophetic tradition that the Sufis considered an excellent of social intercourse. They see in the behavior and actions of their companions the reflection of their own feelings and deeds. And she says about the grouping in Sufi khanqahs. The sixth chapter is Theosophical Sufism. In this part, Shimal explains about some famous mystics such as Suhrawardi, the master of illumination, Ibn al-Arabi, the great master, Ibn al-Farid, mystical poet, and Ibn Arabi's mysticism of unity, Wahdatul Wujud. The seventh chapter is The Rose and Nightingale. In this chapter, Shimal explains about Persian and Turkish mystical poetry, especially about Maulana Jalaluddin Rumi and Turkish popular mysticism. Eighth chapter is Sufism in Indo-Pakistan. In this chapter, Shimal is saying about the classical period of Sufism, the Naqshbandi reaction, Khwaja Mir Dald, a sincere Muhammadian, and also about mystical poetry in language of Sindhi, Punjabi. After this, we conclude this section, and next section is an overview on the famous book, The Mystical Dimension of Islam.